Well, welcome to the Olympic Center here in the 32 Jack Shea Arena. A mixed team relay. That's a unique mixed team competition at the World University Games. Two women per team, one man. They race over 2,000 meters on this 111 meter track. So here we have the confirmed qualifiers for the semi-finals for the mixed team relay. Republic of Korea look a tough team to beat. Top of the pile from China, Netherlands, United States, Kazakhstan, Canada, France and Japan do make it through. Heat number one sees the Republic of Korea, top of the pile, fastest time so far, along with the United States, Kazakhstan and Japan. And we're underway. 18 laps off the track as the USA go into the early lead. Korea already deciding enough's enough. We're going to go up the front. We have our first transition. Choi handing over. Confusing to hear those bells because they do get a bell at the final lap. So the male to female transition, the first one. Korea holding the front line with the USA sitting in second. Kazakhstan and Japan not too far behind. Now a changeover, male to male. With the big lead, the Koreans are prepared to take a wide line out of the bends. Not quite the same for the USA, as Kazakhstan are now hot on the heels at the changeover, and this is the male to female changeover, arguably the toughest of all the transfers. USA catching up, but it's the Olympic champion Choi Min-jun who is leading the way for Korea from the USA. Another transition. A little bit tighter from the Koreans around the bends now. Kazakhstan have dropped off again. And Japan now closing on Kazakhstan, but still Korea from the USA. It's ever so tight, and the USA have just snuck into the lead, but look at that around the bend. Tight on the inside, great control from Korea to retake the lead, and it will be Lee to finish things off for the Koreans. Can he maintain the lead for them? Brandon Kim for the USA sitting in second place. It will be Korea and the USA who take the bell. Japan desperately trying to get up the outside, now trying to transfer to the inside, but it is the Koreans who've taken first place from the USA. Didn't look to be any argy-bargy, apart from perhaps on the very first corner. But crossing the line first, Republic of Korea from the United States of America. The USA had the lead for about a quarter of a lap before the Koreans just stepped on the gas, crossing the line in first place. USA have done enough to qualify for the final. The second semi-final, China versus France, Netherlands and Canada. Top two making it through to the final to join the USA and Korea. So the Netherlands jockeying best for position at the very start. De Boer leading the line from China. And we go to the transitions. This is tight. China taking the inside line this time. China leading for the Netherlands, and the Netherlands have hit the deck and gone out. So France now sit in second place. Canada sitting in third. The Netherlands will potentially go for the transition here, but they're trying to stay out of the way at the moment as China pump out into the lead here. Zhang pulling away, trying to from Grahl, but Grahl sticking on his tail. Going on for Canada, trying to find his man. And that actually gives China the opportunity to pull a little bit further out into the lead. Still incredibly close though. The three of them still in with a shout. China controlling things at the front, holding the line where they need to. Oh, a little slip there, but hands over just about. Wang now just caught up there by the French number 13. That's Levesque. That slip from China, just giving the French an opportunity here, just a sniff of getting into the lead. And if anything, that's just opened things up from Canada behind them. Five to go. We'll get the female-male changeover now. And off trots Zhang again, pumping around that bend. Really building up the potential as he comes out of it, and then using it all. Final transfer, a push over the line, massive push from both the Chinese and the French team. They're going to hear the bell at across the line here. China in control, had enough time to have a look back, and it will be China who take this one from the French, and Canada back in third place. So disappointment for the Netherlands. They've just been overtaken into second place, but we're looking very strong. Had a fall, but the French celebrate as they benefit from that fall. Maybe they would have beaten them anyway, but it made it a lot easier, that's for sure. And here is that's where China just took the lead, and it was just enough to put Otter off, and she crashes into the barrier. Big pushes here from both teams at the front. China and France pulling away from Canada. And crossing the line, there was a little bit of a shaky transition for the last transition for China, but it was they had enough of a lead to pull away. China from France, Canada in third. So confirmation there of the qualifiers. China and France going through into the A final of the mixed team relay. Canada and Netherlands qualify for the B final. As the athletes now make their way onto the ice. So Kazakhstan, Japan, Canada and the Netherlands line up for 18 laps to come in this mixed team relay. B final, Japan taking to the front right from the start, and Netherlands slipping up into second position in the early phases. Japan from the Netherlands, Canada and Kazakhstan. Nakashima Mirai leading the way for the Japanese team. Prepare for the first male to female transition around this bend. Japan with the lead, but look how close they are. Kazakhstan look like they've stepped up into second place from the Netherlands. Canada dropping from second to fourth. Japan going hard here with Wada Takumi. Kazakhstan with Adel Galiakmetov. They'll come round this bend into the male-to-male transition, and Kazakhstan go into the lead. Kazakhstan out with Yekbulan Shamukhanov. Shamukhanov in the lead from Matsuzu Shuta. Netherlands and Canada in a tussle for third position in this B final. Netherlands leading that one at the moment. And now back to the female athletes. Kazakhstan still leading the way. Malika Yermek up front for Kazakhstan. Takahashi Hana will be looking to find a way through if she can, but Canada have slipped the Netherlands. Canada hand over Bellet to Lamarche. Canada pressing hard now on Japan. Japan just holding the line, but Canada have got the inside line into the top bend. And now a handover, male to female. And Kazakhstan leading the way here in this B final. Galiakmetov now looking to hand over to Shamukhanov. Shamukhanov now to finish things off. Coming around the top bend, Shamukhanov gets the bell. Canada have held second place here. Canada going for this, but the Netherlands come up the inside into second place. Oh, a big wobble over the line, but the Netherlands nick it in the end. It's Kazakhstan from the Netherlands. Japan in third. And Canada having a big crash. Justin Berganot hitting the deck, but what a finish there from the Netherlands. Well, look at this transition, so tight. Kazakhstan trailing Japan at that phase, but the push hard from Galiakmetov to take the lead. Canada trying to come around the inside of the Netherlands, and that was the crash for Berganot. Kazakhstan taking the B final from the Netherlands here in the 1932 Jaksha Arena, and it was that man that took the lead. Adil Galiakmetov pressed the afterburners, and off he went. Now, here's the collision. Will the Netherlands get penalised? It's not really much of a penalty, though, because Canada lost their way. It means that Japan will advance into the second position. Canada will go up into third in this B final. So there is a review going on.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please in that last relay.
Well, you see the move here. End of the straight, illegal late pass for the Netherlands. And they have been penalized. So they will drop to no position effectively in the B final. Hitting the crash mats right in the middle. They'll be all right. But it does mean that the Netherlands will not finish in second in the B final here. So time for the A final. Medals up for grabs here. Korea, USA, China and France. Choi Min-jun starting for Korea. And good push there from the USA and Latai to hold second, because it was a great start from the number nine, Wang Yichao from China. Aurélie Levesque sitting at the back for France as we go through the first transition. The second female athlete coming out, and it's Kim Jun-hee leading for the Koreans. Corinne Stoddard in second place, China, with Hao Weiying in third, are looking in a strong position. Well, France have been dropped here. Looks like the contest already is between Korea the USA and China. Good transition for both the USA and China. Korea now starting to pull away. Jang Sung-woo. But USA closing the gap really quickly. And now the pair of them have dropped China a little bit. Early doors. USA pushing to the front here. USA go into the lead here. And look at the cheer from the crowd as they hand over. Julia Letai up front for the USA. She goes up against Choi Min-jun. And China on a press as well here up front. Korea steal the lead back. Choi Min-jun a fall for China, but the transition was made, but China have dropped off the front two now. Korea leading the USA. Kim Jun-hee pushing hard, but so is the USA's Karin Stoddard. They make the handover now to the men. The men pushing hard, Korea on with Kim Tae-sun. Kim Tae-sun now looking for the handover to Jang Sung-woo. Here's the final push. Jang Sung-woo leading from Brandon Kim. Brandon Kim trying to hunt him down here. They get the bell. They're going to get the bell in the next round. China back in this, but they're a little far behind. Korea pushing at the bell, and it is now Jang Sung-woo fighting for the line. Brandon Kim trying to get there, but Korea take it from the USA. China in third. What a race in the mixed team final. Korea from the USA and China. Well, USA though, they put up a big fight there, a massive fight. But the Koreans were ready. They fought back, and it's gold medal number three for Choi Min-jun, taking the 1500 and the 500 in the women's individual. Now taking gold in the mixed team competition. Of course, it's subject to the referee's decision, but there wasn't a huge amount on show. Here's the takeover here from Kim Min-jun, having to press hard to get around the American Julia Letai. And here's where the crash happened. In the transition, it was the two athletes that were pushing off and sending, handing over the baton, if you like, getting connected with each other. So it didn't really affect the race that much. Perhaps held up the push off from the Chinese, which is why the gap built up so quickly. They fought back hard, but it was Korea up front, as always here, it seems, leading at the front and staying out of trouble. Korea taking the mixed team gold medal here at the FISU World University Games of 2023 in Lake Placid. Korea from the USA and China.
In that last relay, there was a penalty on a team from France.
I'm told that there are actually three separate incidents that they are looking at. So now, when we're looking at this review, it's got to be now about whether the transition from Korea has happened before they cross the line. There's a certain time, a certain space in the straits that they're allowed to make the transition. And we just wait to hear what's being announced. So transition from France penalized. Now they're arguing their case here. He looks clean at the front. So we're looking for transitions here. Well, we're looking at this and can't really see anything different other than the French not making an exchange here. Now, are France right? Have France followed all the rules and made the transitions at the right time, and the other three teams have made a transition one lap or half a lap even too early? Now, if this is the case, of course, France have to take the gold medal, even though they came across the line in fourth place. The question then is, who do you award the silver and bronze medals to if all three other teams have broken the rules? So there is a mistake. We heard the head referee saying there has been an error here. The French have put up a good argument here. We saw in the replays, looking, thinking, well, why? What's the problem here? But the problem was only three teams made the transition. Well, would you look at that? There was a problem with the lap counter. That's why the teams made the transition, but the French were so smart, so cute in that situation. They did not believe the lap counter. They believed themselves that they hadn't done enough rotations of the lap. And that means the French, coming through in fourth place, will take the gold medal. Now, the question is, what happens to the other teams? I've got to tell you, I've got no idea. So the French promoted to the gold medal here in the mixed team competition. The judge seemed to have said that the lap counter was wrong, and it was slightly delayed, I have to say. Counts down the laps here in the short track speed skating. So as you're coming around the top bend into the final straight where the lap counter, you can see the lap counter in front of you. It's one lap behind, effectively. So you have to feel for the Koreans, the USA and China, because, well, they were going off what the referees were telling them. Well, here we have the confirmation of the results from the mixed team event in the short track speed skating. France taking the gold medal in a heavily penalized A final that saw the Netherlands, Korea and USA kicked out for making a transition too early. First place Kazakhstan in the B final move into silver medal position and Japan collect the bronze medal. How important is that B final now? Well, providing all the drama here tonight in the short track speed skating arena, it was the mixed team competition, the newest event here. If you think you've seen everything, you haven't seen short track speed skating.